This is the tallest building you have made in height. You are like in a plane. I think some people have the feeling they are the king because they are higher. It is not a center of the city. It's not a project which you can see the same tower from everywhere. It is a project whose importance would be that it is addressing Central Park. In this way, from everywhere, you understand where is the north, where is the south, and east and west. You have really an orientated building. The shaping of the building, part of it came from the fact that the site itself is not a square, it's not a rectangle, it's an angle. So I organized a series of curves, making like a cascade, which was a way to include every volume and to unify them. So the littler part on the side and the upper part on the main part of the building have the same dynamic of curve facing Central Park. The difference in the west and east, it was to have sort of a play of rectangle, like the pixel of an image. I said sometime like the painting of Gustav Klimt, the Austrian painter, which would use some different color of glass, creating an animated facade, which express also that you have many floors, you have many people. Gary Barnett from Extel was very involved in all of this. He said to me, I am very good with color. You cannot cheat me with the color of the glass. And he recognized it was true that with the lines in a living room, you had some slight differences of the color of the grass of Central Park. You would have a little different, which was not acceptable. So we unified the glass of the north. It's feeling a good continuity, good achievement, and a sense of, I would say, gratitude to the city. I would not pretend it changed Manhattan, but it's true that this one would be recognizable in this place.